final. when we present them, when we explain them, tell them what they need to do, what our process is all about, and also let them watch our process, how it performs. I think this is really a very nice new contribution to the information systems field. As far as we know, well, we have used animation, we have used various other multimedia techniques to improve the comprehension of processes, but we haven't used this before, so we contribute with a new multimedia approach for improving process model comprehension. And we also observe interesting results like the diversity on the impact of narration on different descriptions. Well, we did this investigation only on process models and with two different types of descriptions. If we consider the use of narration for other types of conceptual models and different descriptions that you can provide for different conceptual models, you have such a diversity of opportunities on how to use narration, but of course the impact will differ. And the way you need to design the narration solution would also differ, so we believe that it's really an interesting research opportunity to further consider. And we should also check other factors, especially user characteristics, for example, is really important. So I mentioned that with our results, for example, the flow descriptions weren't significantly impacted through the use of narration. Maybe it's because our users had already some considerable process modeling knowledge. They didn't really need that kind of explanations. But if we look at more novice users, maybe they would also benefit from it in a more significant way. So that's also interesting to look at. And, of course, I've mentioned the use of animation and narration. And using these two solutions, multimedia approaches in an integrated way, is really interesting. And there are so many different ways that you can combine them. Our approach was in a more passive way right now to have a controlled environment. But, for example, we also develop an interactive animation approach. And with this interactivity, the user has much more opportunity to investigate the process model in detail, and you can combine it with narration in different ways also. So how to design these kinds of environments, modeling environments, it's really interesting. And for organizations, we see a very good opportunity for users to increase the adoption of modeling environments, because with the modeling environments, it's usually difficult for users to have a sustainable use of that kind of process information. But if users are like this environment, like to use this environment more, then they would come back and check process information and increase their knowledge better, which would result in improved process execution. Well, and finally, you can ask, okay, what about how to implement all this? Actually, considering these text-to-speech algorithm improvements and also the API API improvements with the modeling tools and natural language processing improvements with all the textual data, it's quite easy right now to automate all this process of developing such a solution, which we suggest for organization for tool developers. Well, thanks for listening, and I'm in the information systems group. As you see, I'm really interested in business processes and innovating business processes, and I always have a human perspective and organizational perspective. We do a lot of different types of work. I would be very happy to take your questions now and also discuss about all these later. Thank you.
Thank you. Questions?
Very interesting presentation. Thank you very much. I have two questions. So when you're enriching your process models with narrations, you're basically applying dual coding theory there. But it also comes at expense of complexity. You're also adding more information to the process model that needs to be processed and integrated. So is there any considerations regarding, for instance, how long a narration should be, or what is a good explanation, what is a good narration, so it doesn't affect cognitive load? And the second one is, did you also consider correctness as part of the variables, of the dependent variables that you were checking?
With the process
Yes.
Okay, next questions.
Thanks for the presentation. I thought it was very interesting. One of the things I found interesting probably wasn't what you expected, though. When I looked at the diagram that you asked people to look at, I thought, wow, that is really ugly. It's not a comment about whether it's bad. It's a comment about aesthetically, I really wouldn't want to look at something like that. And so I wonder whether there's something about people in this field inflicting that kind of thing on people who really just don't want to even look at it, and that maybe there should be levels of description where one level of description might be a good narration, just period, no picture, just a good narration, or a good animation, and then like selectively revealing what's there so that people don't get overwhelmed.
Interactive animation where you let user choose through step by step. Well, we don't exactly do that completely interactive as you suggest, I think, but partly. But I agree that exactly would be much more useful, I would imagine, for the users, for the process model readers, to interact in a more flexible way, check the narrations and everything. It would be, I think, much more efficient way of using narration, actually.
I also have a question along those lines. Recently, we did a change management project in one company. So there was a process model and other models, and it was the proposal for the new way of working. And then we showed it to people, and we kind of evaluated it. And a lot of comments that we got was that, of course, it was on Zoom. It has to be in 1 hour. And people say, well, I only want to know what I do. So in these kind of narrations, would be nice if they could kind of tailor, give me the whole thing, give me the overview, or give me only for one role or one part of the process, or the...
Exactly. Yes, I also recognize it as an issue or as a feature for users. Actually, here in this prototype, it's really not implemented fully, but we have these show filters, and then you can choose only one role, and then it takes you through the activities of that role. Yeah, I agree. That's something that people would like to have.
And companies have done some things like that with text, because there are sort of internal company websites where there are process models, and then you click on it, and you get the table that you showed. So that maybe needs to be... Yeah.
And then, we need to consider the solution that combines both the graphical and the textual information, right? That's a nice...
I think we have one more question.
Okay. Where I would think of, and I did think of it before you asked the question, is the idea of sub-processes, so that you can level it and that you say, well, this inner block, for instance, we call it blah, 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 and then it's only one thing, and you can zoom in and blah, 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 and then you can also say, okay, for a person, and that person, and Stephen is only over there, so the rest can be one block, or, and you can level it.
Yeah, that's definitely a good approach to manage complexity.
And yeah, in general.
Last question.
Just so if I understood correctly, you proved the hypothesis for elements, but not for flows, right?
For both, there is improvement.
Yeah.
But the difference is not significant for flow descriptions.
Yeah, and my question was more like, what is the hypothesis? What is your explanation for that? Because I elements already, like activities or the like, already have textual labels. So my initial idea would be, well, I can just enrich the textual label there. But for flows, it's a little bit more implicit. So what is your hypothesis on how could we better generate better narrations for that?
Level of our users, they reported themselves, but it was really high. So perhaps they already, and also as Stephen was suggesting, our process model has a good block structure, and they have good knowledge of the modeling BPM and language, so they could already capture it themselves. So either narration or textual description on the screen, it didn't differ that much for them, because they could already go through it themselves, capture that information. But for the rest, for the like more hidden information, when we narrated rather than letting them read it, that helped more. This also helped us a bit differentiate between the effects of animation and narration, because that's also, I will start criticizing myself, but with this study, it's a bit of a challenge to differentiate if the improvement comes from the animation or narration. But we believe this also a bit shows that narration really helps, because especially with these animations, but yeah, that's a good point, important point to pay attention to.
So the next paper could be called Don't Show Me What I Don't Want to See.
Yes, exactly.
Okay, let's conclude on that. Thank you, Bono, for a nice presentation.